Hello nerds, in today's video I'm going to show you how to use OrcaSlicer and make cuts and connectors. This is a really cool feature where you can basically print any size model you want because you can cut it however you want, and you can add these little connectors to make sure that it fits well together. This is awesome. You don't have to go into modeling software to do this. You can do this right after loading your model. So these ones are plug type, which means they protrude from one side and then they have a corresponding hole. And these ones are called snap. And they actually have dowels as well. And let's just add a cube in here and we will start cutting to show how that all works. So I've got this cube right here and we will perform the cut. And you do have options in the mode. You can choose to make it a dovetail cut. And if you look, that cut will be dovetailed like this. You can change your tolerances here. As you can see, I don't know if you can see that. As you can see that it changes your width around here and your depth. So for most people, probably like 0.07, somewhere in down here should be pretty good as long as your printer settings are dialed in. You can also change all these settings in here, and you have the option to flip or keep. So I'm just going to show you what it does when you flip it. It'll flip it down. Don't be alarmed, you're able to click onto objects and then onto which piece you want, and then you're able to pull it away. And you can actually then just make sure that you print it in the right orientation, so you could auto orient it just to not have to worry about any of those overhangs. Okay, so let's get rid of that and we will try some of the other settings. So let's try a cylinder this time and let's go ahead and go back up to that cut. And when you do cut, you're able to move that cut however you'd like. I am making this video because one of my subscribers asked about how this cut feature works. So let's choose to make it a planar cut. And then you got some, this is where you have some really cool options. So you can add connectors. And as you see, there's the three different types. And we will just go through them really quick. So you have prism style and you can make circles. You can make it into a triangle, you can make it into a square, or you can make it into a hexagon. You also have this option to make them frustum, and you do have the same shape settings. So let's just make a hexagon for this tutorial, and you can see that you can change the depth and your size. And I think a tolerance for these of 0.1 is pretty good for most people. And then you can also rotate it around. So I'm gonna say that looks good. And you know what, actually, let's add one more. So let's just say I wanted this, but I also wanted a dowel. And the dowel is the same thing, but it's gonna go, it's gonna put a hole basically in both sides of the model, and then the dowel prints out on its own. So let's just say, I like that, but I want a dowel too. And we'll make the dowel a circle dowel. And we'll leave those settings the same. So we click right there. Oh, I thought it was gonna let me do both of them. Let's see. Okay, we can confirm. We're not gonna flip this time just to show what it looks like if it stays. And there we go. As you can see, it changed it to dowel. I guess it doesn't like to do both of them together, but I know you can do two different shapes. So if you look right there, we got it all arranged. You can print your dowels and you can print your two pieces of the model, and then you can glue them together. Okay, so let's get rid of that and let's look into the snap setting. So let's add primitive. We'll add a sphere this time. Let's cut that. And we will add our connector, and this time we'll do the snap connector. And one of the cool things about the snap connector is you get some more options besides just your depth and size. You can actually change the bulge in the connector. So I'm going to zoom in a little just to see it real close up. So you can make that bulge right there larger. And if you want to get rid of the, if you accidentally click one and want to get rid of it, you could either right click or you hit delete. And you can also change how big this space is. So like with different types of materials, you'll probably have different flexibilities and you can change how big that space is. You can also rotate it around. Let's see why it's not rotating. So that one's rotating. Let's get rid of it. And let's see, there we go. Now we got it rotating. Okay, so let's say that looks good. We're gonna confirm and we're gonna perform our cut. And there we go, pull it across. I'm just gonna rotate that out so we can see how it looks. And there we go, we got the hole and the snap. And one of the nice things about the snap is you can kind of rotate it. So it's kind of nice for something that you don't want to change the model, but you want to make it like articulated, you know, like an arm on a action figure or something. Okay, so those are all the different connector settings. And hopefully this helps. I think it's really cool that we can do this in our slicer now. If you have something, you know, way too large, you can slice it up and put it on different plates. And just make sure that you orient your objects for printing the as well as you can. And when you need to move them, you click into your objects. Well, thank you again for still watching this tutorial. If you have any other questions, I am happy to make tutorials and provide some answers for you. And I also have a Discord where we have about 5 members now, I think, and we talk about 3D printing and technology, and it's really, really awesome community. And if you did enjoy this video, consider giving me a like and or a subscribe. I will be releasing a lot more videos and tutorials and even a Gajuino build coming up soon. So I will get to work on that, and I will see you nerds on the other side. Bye.